Poems to Fall in Love With, chosen by Chris Riddell and read by Juliet Stevenson and David Rintoul. Love and Friendship by Emily Bronte. Love is like the wild rose briar, friendship like the holly tree. The holly is dark when the rose briar blooms, but which will bloom most constantly? The wild rose briar is sweet in spring, its summer blossoms scent the air, yet wait till winter comes again, and who will call the wild briar fair? Then scorn the silly rose wreath now, and deck thee with the holly's sheen, that when December blights thy brow, he still may leave thy garland green. Locks by Neil Gaiman. We owe it to each other to tell stories as people, simply, not as father and daughter. I tell it to you for the 100th time. There was a little girl called Goldilocks, for her hair was long and golden, and she was walking in the wood, and she saw
cows.
You say it with certainty, remembering the strayed heifers we saw in the woods behind the house last month. Well, yes, perhaps she saw cows, but also she saw a house.
A great big house,
you tell me. No, a little house, all painted, neat and tidy.
A great big house.
You have the conviction of all two-year-olds. I wish I had such certitude. Ah, yes, a great big house. And she went in. I remember, as I tell it, that the locks of Southey's heroine had silvered with age. The old woman and the three bears. Perhaps they had been golden once, when she was a child. And now we are already up to the porridge. And it was too
hot.
And it was too
cold.
And then it was, we chorus, just right. The porridge is eaten, the baby's chair is shattered. Goldilocks goes upstairs, examines beds, and sleeps unwisely. But then the bears return. Remembering Southey still, I do the voices. Father Bear's gruff boom scares you, and you delight in it. When I was a small child and heard the tale, if I was anyone, I was Baby Bear. My porridge eaten and my chair destroyed, my bed inhabited by some strange girl. You giggle when I do the baby's wail.
Someone's been eating my porridge and they've eaten it all up,
you say. A response it is, or an amen. The bears go upstairs hesitantly. Their house now feels desecrated. They realize what locks are for. They reach the bedroom.
Someone's been sleeping in my bed.
And here I hesitate, echoes of old jokes, softcore cartoons, crude headlines in my head. One day your mouth will curl at that line. A loss of interest, later innocence. Innocence as if it were a commodity. And if I could, my father wrote to me, huge as a bear himself when I was younger, I would dower you with experience without experience. And I, in my turn, would pass that on to you. But we make our own mistakes. We sleep unwisely. It is our right. The repetition echoes down the years. When your children grow, when your dark locks begin to silver, when you are an old woman alone with your three bears, what will you see? What stories will you tell? And then Goldilocks jumped out of the window and she ran, together now, all the way home. And then you say,
again, again, again.
We owe it to each other to tell stories.
Postcards from the Hedgehog by A.F. Harold. Dear Mum, beautiful weather. I saw a fox last night. Did as you always said and rolled into a ball. After a while it went away. I was a bit scared all the same. Wish you were here. Love, Simon. Dear Mum, lovely weather today. Just saw a really pretty girl. Not sure how to approach her. She makes me really shy, but just all warm inside. I rolled up into a ball. Wish you were here. Love, Simon. Dear Mum, it's raining today. I ate a slug. Wasn't as good as the ones you used to give us. Tomorrow I think I'll approach the girl. Perhaps I'll take her a slug. She makes me ever so nervous. I rolled up into a ball. Wish you were here. Love, Simon. Dear Mum, sun's come out again. This morning I was very brave, and I went to see her. I edged up very carefully, as you suggested, but when I spoke to her, I discovered she was actually a pine cone. I felt very embarrassed. Rolled up into a ball. Wish you were here. Love, Simon. La Belle Dame Sans Merci by John Keats. Oh, what can ail thee, knight at arms, alone and palely loitering? The sedge has withered from the lake, and no bird.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.